content and language integrated learning. We are not just going to learn English, we are going to learn things related to tourism as well. And because you study tourism and you want to be who knows what in the tourism industry, I hope you will like it. So, in order to begin, I would like to ask you to think of some jobs related to tourism. Not necessarily jobs that you want to have one day, but jobs that people have in the tourism sector. Okay, can you think of some jobs and maybe write them on the blackboard? Please.
Chef.
Chef, okay. Because you like food.
Yes, no.
Okay, what else?
Travel agent.
A travel agent, good. Please.
Hotel manager.
Would you like to be a hotel manager?
Yes.
Yeah, sure, why not? What else? What's your name?
Craftsman.
Craftsman?
Yes.
Is? What is a craftsman? What do you call it in Romanian? In Romanian, craftsman.
Meșteșugar.
Okay. Sure, craftsman. Good.
Waiter.
Waiter. Or for women, we call them waitress. Waitresses. Okay. Would you like to be a waitress?
Yeah.
Okay, waiter, craftsman, travel agent. What else?
Concierge.
Concierge. He works in a hotel. Okay, in a 3- or 4-star hotel. Would you like to work as a concierge?
No.
No. You have higher expectations. Everyone wants to be a hotel manager, I think, right?
Yeah.
What else?
Tour guide.
A tour guide. Would you like to be a tour guide?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. Please, my tour guide. So, tour guides, okay. I don't know if you are considering becoming a tour guide, even in your spare time or doing it as a part job while you are studying in university. But if you are interested in becoming a tour guide, there are a few things you need to know. First, there are some skills that you need to have in order to be a good tour guide and to gain more money. Let's take some tips, okay, from the people who are coming to you and waiting for you to present them the site. Now, we are going to look at some of the skills that are considered important for tour guides. You have a worksheet, one for each team, and what you have to do is match the skill with the description. Okay? They are mixed. And then we are going to read them and discuss. You should try to consider which one is more important or which ones are more important, okay, for a tour guide. Try to work in teams and discuss. And if you have any questions or words that you don't understand, don't hesitate to ask. Okay? Just draw lines from A to the first column to the second. Okay? Marina.
A tour guide must be articulated and easy to understand and also have the interpersonal skills necessary to interact with the new people every single day, answer questions, and be approachable.
Okay, so interpersonal skills, interacting with people and answering questions. Good. The second one, memory, storytelling. Catherine.
When you run a tour, you are selling knowledge, history and the story. If you are reading off a card or getting facts wrong, the guest will not be impressed.
Okay, so you need to know the facts.
Yes.
It is an important skill for a tour guide, what do you think?
Yes,
yeah, so know the, all the details about the site you're presenting. The next one, the third one, humor is A, B, C, D, E, which one?
E.
E? Okay, who wants to read? Please.
No one wants a dry boring history lesson. A guide with a good sense of humor will be able to make the guests feel at ease and happy, increasing their enjoyment of the tour.
Okay, so you would enjoy the tour more if the person presenting it is has a good sense of humor, right? Good. Passion? Please.
A tour guide who loves his or her job will show you the amazing things to see in the area and inspire you to ask questions and get deep into the history of destination.
Good. So passion. You need to love your job. Okay? If you don't like what you are doing, it shows. Flexibility. Yes. Did you find it? Flexibility? Did you find the description? D? Please.
This skill is important because it allows the guide to adjust for spontaneous moments and use a unique approach for different types of guests.
For different types of guests. Not all the guests you are going to receive are similar, so you need to be aware of that. Next, punctuality. Steffi, did you find the answer for punctuality? Okay.
No one wants to sit around waiting for a guide. It's incredibly unprofessional. The best guides are able to organize the groups of tourists so that there are few delays as possible.
Okay. And the last one, which is obvious, but let's read the description anyway. Sensitivity, Magda.
Guests can come in from all over the globe, and they will have certain cultural, expectation and social norms. The best tour guides are sensitive to this international difference and can tailor their speech to respect their guests when possible.
Mm-hmm. Good. So you need to respect your guests and their customs and where they come from. Now, if you were to make, let's say, top three of the most important skills, of course, all these skills are important, but let's say top three, which one would you choose? Which ones, sorry?
Passion.
Communication.
And memory.
Okay, so passion, you need to really love what you are doing. And if you study tourism, you are supposed to love what you are doing. Communication, like answering questions. And memory, okay, to have a good memory to remember all the facts because otherwise no one would listen to you, okay, or hire you as a guide. Now, about passion, it's really obvious, but for the next two skills, I have a set of exercises for you. The first one refers to communication and knowing how to answer the guests' questions. You have another worksheet with a dialogue between the guests and the tour guide. And there are some questions you need to fill in, the questions of the people for the tour guide. Then you are going to perform the role play in front of the class. Okay? I will choose three people, because we have three roles for this exercise. So, have a look maybe you can offer. Do you need another one? So you have 2 minutes, okay, to read the role, to read the dialogue, find the questions, and then I will ask you to come in front of the class to perform it. Okay? Please.
Yes.
possible guests, okay, in English, of course. But before doing that, because when we speak about a village, a village museum, we may encounter some difficult vocabulary, I have prepared an exercise for you with some words that might come in handy when you prepare your speeches about the village museum. Okay?
Yes.
So, what you need to do is, I have work in pairs this time, and try to fill in the blanks with the missing words. The information you have in the sentence should be enough for you to figure out the missing word, but if it's not enough, just ask and I'll give you more details, okay? Just work in pairs. Flour and bread and just buy the flour and prepare what they need to prepare. Can you cook?
No.
French fries. French fries. No need for flour. Good. Six? Please.
The horses in the stables have plenty of water to drink.
Mm-hmm. The horses in the stables. Stables? Yes. Yes. Good. Next, please.
Some of the shingles on the roof are missing.
Shingles.
Shingles.
Yes. What does it mean?
Shingle.
Okay. Do you have shingles on your houses?
No.
Do you know that shingles is also a word used for a disease? No? Caused by a virus? You've never heard of it. We call it zona zoster. No. Okay. Hope you won't get it. Next. The eighth one. Please.
The citadel had a water mill which was used for grinding corn.
For grinding corn. Okay. Do we have a water mill now? In Suceava?
No.
But we used to have more. How about in your villages? Do you have a water mill?
No.
No? You don't? Not a water mill, but you have a mill, right?
Yes.
Okay. But it's all electric power. Okay, nothing with water. And we do have a water mill at the village museum.
Yes.
Did you see it there?
Yes.
And nine? Guta?
The plates are painted by our fine craftsmen.
Mm-hmm. Craftsmen, we discussed. Do you think that's an easy job?
No.
Would you like to learn some products, sculpting or painting?
Yes.
Maybe you'll get the chance to on your summer holiday. If you go to the village museum, there are craftsmen willing to teach you how to do some of these things. And the last one? Who would like to read the last one? Please.
The rock, pine, and beech are the main varieties of trees.
Varieties of trees. What is oak? Sejar, yes. Pine?
Yeah.
That's easy. And beech is
bark.
And you'll see that many of the houses in the village museum are built with beech wood. I don't know the difference, but this is what they say, so it's supposed to be good. Okay. Now, if you know these words, your next task is going to be easier, or a little more easy, because you will need to learn a few facts about some of the buildings we can find in the village museum, and then you will present it for the visitors.